This is Pastor Phil, Full of Life Ministries. I am so honored and thrilled to be with you all once again. And right now, I am giving you a spiritual high five. I'm giving you a fist bump. And just a big old hug. You see, it's wonderful to be here, right in front of this microphone, sharing my love for you and to share the love of Jesus everywhere I go. You have to understand that His love never withdraws itself or overreacts to our shortcomings. You see, the love that Jesus has for the world never flinches because we fall short or because we allow our emotions to dictate our actions. Yes, we fall down, but the Lord helps us to get back up again on our feet to give us direction. And there's somebody right now that's listening to me under the sound of my voice. You're in a difficult situation and you can't see your way. You can't see your way out of this obstacle. And all of your resources are either running real low or you are right now financially tapped out. I am here to let you know that the Lord is going to bring you through this difficult situation. You need to know and you need to realize who you serve. We serve an awesome God. We serve a faithful God, and He is ready and willing to help you through this difficult time in your life. You see, I'm reminded of a scripture that's found in Psalms 121, verses 1 through 3. And this particular psalm is a pilgrimage song. Songs of ascent were sung by pilgrims making their way to Jerusalem, which was located in a mountainous area. And the purpose of these pilgrims singing this song while journeying up these mountains was to go to Jerusalem to attend its annual festivals and to worship God. You see, worshiping the Lord while going up a steep mountain filled with challenges and uncertainty had to be difficult for these precious souls. But thinking about this analogy of the mountains, they are filled with lessons we can learn in life. This could help us build our faith in God to believe that you can overcome any obstacle that is set before you. You are right now at the bottom of the hills looking up. I want to say that one more time. You are right now at the bottom, level one, and you're looking at the hills. You lift your eyes to the hills, and your mind is filled with various thoughts, many thoughts. Some are good and some are troubling. Some thoughts are really full of fear, anxiety, anxious. Whatever those thoughts are, you know what those thoughts that you feel within your spirit that are telling you certain things. Because in our thoughts, you can look at it this way, that you're looking right now at the hills before you and actually be afraid of what is before you. Because in the hills, there could be robbers waiting to devour you, to hurt you, to rob you of certain things. And not just robbing you of your material things, but robbing you of your peace, your joy, your hope of succeeding in life, opportunities to learn and to grow, just an opportunity just to be happy. Yeah, there are things that are sitting there to try to take away things that are so critical for your life. And there could be some wicked people that you may have to encounter on this road, these hills. These individuals are looking to take advantage of your kindness. Yes, there are people in our world, they look to take advantage of your kindness, your generosity, your patience. These are wicked people. Or it could be on your mountain as you stand at the bottom of your mountain. It could be an enemy that's trying to tempt you into falling for something that in the long run will be detrimental to your overall life and your overall health for life. So in this Psalms, these pilgrims, these followers of the Lord are going up this mountain. They are lifting their eyes to the hills. And the writer presents a question that states, from where does my help come from? How am I going to get through this mountain that stands in my way? We know where we want to go, but we're not too sure if we're going to make it. Have you ever been there that you know exactly where you want to go? The place that you really believe that you're going to really find fulfillment and purpose and freedom? You can see it. You can sense it in your spirit, but yet, how are we going to get there? Will we be able to make it on this journey? What could go wrong in this journey? Now you have to understand, there's the possibility of becoming overwhelmed with fear. Or maybe the mountain is just too hard to climb. Yes, sometimes those mountains look so difficult and you feel like you're not prepared to climb these hills. It could be daunting. It could be intimidating to most people. And then there's the suggestion from the enemy that maybe your best bet is just to turn around and go home. But what I love of what the writer presents to us today, he finally tells himself the truth. He finally, after going through all these litany of possibilities, he looks within himself and he looks up past the mountains and he begins to tell himself the truth. God's word declares that the truth will set you free. Obviously, the lies keep you in bondage, but God's truth will set you free. He says, my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. You see, now his confidence is now sound and secure. His faith has been boosted and ready to attack. He realizes now that he has help. That he's not by himself. He recognizes that the Lord is greater than the mountains. Matter of fact, he created the mountains. Yes, he did. And he knows what's on the mountain. And he will give you clear direction and endurance to overcome the mountains that stand before you. And the good news is, you can sing and you can praise the Lord and worship God while you're climbing your mountains. Praise is our weapon against the things that could come out of nowhere that try to bring harm to us, that will try to disturb our spirits, that will worry us, to bring concerns, to make you feel like you don't have enough. You can sing songs to worship God and to just get excited for getting through the mountains before you actually get through the mountains. You'll climb up those mountains anticipating a moment with God because you're worshiping God. You're singing songs. You're full of joy. You're not worried anymore. Matter of fact, you have been empowered through song to worship God, to let the enemy know that there is nothing that could hinder me from getting to my destination. These pilgrims knew that they were going to get to Jerusalem to worship and to experience God. So they knew that even though they didn't feel that they had all that they need to face their challenges, they knew within themselves, because they knew the truth. God will never allow for anything that's on those mountains to bring harm to your life. I see. People of God, today or tonight's episode is one filled with assurances, guarantees that no matter how difficult life gets, no matter the strains and the stresses that life presents to us, we can be confident of this very thing. And as Philippians, the first chapter, the sixth verse tells us, it says, the one who started a good work in you. Now, this is the key. It says, will stay with you to complete the job by the day of Christ Jesus. God is going to stay with us. He's not fair weathered. He's not intimidated. He's not concerned. If he's not concerned, since he's driving us to our destination, why should we be concerned? Amen and amen. You have to understand, people of God, when you are in a battle against the enemy, you're going to need backup. I'm going to say that one more time. When you are in a battle, when you're in a fight against the enemy, when you are in a struggle, when you're trying to navigate your way through life and you see all the obstacles and the things that could potentially create havoc for your life, you're going to need to call backup. A police officer never goes into a dangerous situation without backup, because having assistance is necessary in order to apprehend the offender who is causing problems in your life. But many of us are fighting battles that we're not prepared to fight. We're not ready to fight these battles. We don't use the right tools to fight the battles. And oftentimes that's why we are left defeated. It's because we're using the wrong tools. We say self can defeat our adversaries, only to find out that self becomes selfish. And when you run out of bullets, when you are trying to win a battle that's over your head, you will be defeated. But God wants for you to totally rely on him, to totally rely on him to help you overcome the various trials that's in your life. And what the Lord has impressed upon me is to reassure you that if you put your faith in God, he will make everything all right. So today or tonight's episode is entitled, We'll Go Through This Together. I'm going to say that one more time. We will go through this together. Let's take a quick commercial break and we'll be right back with the episode entitled, We'll Go Through This together.
Hello, hello. My name is Christopher. I'm the editor of Full of Life Ministries San Diego podcast. And first of all, I'd like to say thank you so much for listening. We really appreciate it. But I would also like to say that if you would like any prayer, any words of encouragement, or would just like to reach out in any way, you can email us at fullofLifeSD@gmail.com. Also, we have a Twitter account. Our handle is @fullofLifeSD. And feel free to reach out. We would love to hear from you. And lastly, I would like to say if you like what you're hearing and would like to donate, you can donate on any one of our pages. If you go to any of our pages, Spotify, Google, Spreaker, any of that, there should be a link that allows you to do so if that interests you. That's all for me. So thank you guys for listening and enjoy the rest of the podcast.
All right, we are back. And so let's get into today or tonight's episode entitled, We Will Go Through This Together. Now, one of the things that we need to understand is going through the various trials that life presents to us to make a difference in this world, to experience the love and teachings that the Lord provides for us so our society can see that living for the Lord will make the difference. Yes, we are going through troubled times. We are going through difficult times. We don't know exactly what our future holds, but we do know who holds our future. We could be difference makers because of how we handled these challenges. And the objective here is to really understand that you're not by yourself, that you have somebody who can tap you on the shoulder, who can stand before you to be in front and in back of you to protect you from those onslaughts that the enemy will try to attack you with. Here's the one who comforts us. He is the one who comforts us in all of our troubles so that we can comfort other people who are in every kind of trouble. We offer the same comfort that we ourselves receive from God. That is because we receive so much comfort through Christ in the same way that we share so many of Christ's sufferings. So if we have trouble, it is to bring you comfort and salvation. If we are comforted, it is to bring you comfort from the experience of endurance while you go through the same sufferings that we also suffer. This is found in 2 Corinthians, the first chapter, verses 4 through 6. I want to read that one more time because we have to understand that living in this world, we have to understand that God is with us in every type of circumstance. So in this scripture, it says, and this is the Apostle Paul writing to the church at Corinth. He says, he's the one, referring to God, who comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort other people who are in every kind of trouble. Very powerful line. We offer the same comfort that we ourselves receive from God. That is because we receive so much comfort through Christ in the same way that we share so many of Christ's sufferings. So, if we have trouble, it is to bring you comfort and salvation. If we are comforted, it is to bring you comfort from the experience of endurance while you go through the same sufferings that we also suffer. People of God, when you go through challenges in life, when you're faced with the mountains in your life, the Lord God comforts us. The Lord God encourages us, whether by words or having his presence around us to help us in the time of need, he comforts us. You see, God is the God of all comfort. Jesus promised the disciples that another counselor who would be with them forever, and that's the Holy Spirit. He is the Spirit of truth. He will be sent in the name of Jesus, and he will teach all things relating to what Jesus had taught them. So you have to understand that the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, brings us comfort in all seasons and areas in our lives. Every time that we have a need, the Holy Spirit is there. Every time that we're faced with uncertainty, we have the Holy Spirit to lean on during these difficult times. So number one, when we go through these types of challenges, the Holy Spirit, God, comforts us. Number two, he provides salvation. The Lord God provides for us salvation. And salvation is simply deliverance from danger or suffering. To save is to deliver or to protect. And that word carries the ideal of victory. Hallelujah. It really describes health or preservation. Salvation means being rescued by God from the consequences of our wrongdoing. Like I said earlier, that some of the situations that we are faced with, some of it we did not cause, but then other occasions, we create these troubles because we live in sin. Salvation is what rescued us from the consequences of our wrongdoing. The Lord has rescued you from sin and has created the opportunity for you to succeed. And number three, he gives power to the faint. And to him who has no might, he increases strength. This is found in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 29, that he gives us strength when we become weary. And many of us understand what weariness is. Because when the pressures from life brings exhaustion, we become weary. It's that moment in life when we feel like we cannot carry the burden any longer. That's weariness. That's when we become faint. We become spiritually lightheaded. We feel faint. Now, if we faint, we quit fighting. And our faith becomes shaky. And now fainting leads to trying something that places you vulnerable to the enemy's schemes. But the good news is he gives strength and takes away the weariness all at the same time. He gives us strength and takes away your weariness, your burdens, your weights. Now listen, as the Bible declares in 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter and the 9th verse, it says, he said to me, my grace is enough for you, because power, God's power, is made perfect in weakness. So it goes on to say, so I'll gladly spend my time bragging about my weaknesses so that Christ's power can rest on me. He gives power. While we're going through this difficult time together, the Lord God gives us power for those who are weary, who feel lightheaded. He gives us strength, and he increases our strength because we rest in him. And so in closing, today or tonight's episode is to let everybody know under the sound of my voice that whatever state you find yourself in, be content in knowing that you have a God whose main objective is to love you and to protect you and to provide for you and to show you a better way to live. People of God, remember God's word when it tells us in Deuteronomy, the 31st chapter and the 6th verse, it says, be strong. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. This is God's promise to us today or tonight. Let's embrace this truth, because he is telling us today or tonight, he is simply saying, you're not by yourself. I am with you. So guess what? Man, woman of God, child of God, we are going to go through this situation together in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this time that we could come to you to just allow you to just minister to our hearts. We thank you for all that you have done for us. Every day you continue to bless us, day in, day out, morning, noon, evening, night. You are always with us. And we celebrate you this day, oh God, that because you continue to make sacrifices for us. In spite of ourselves, in spite of our shortcomings, you continue to provide the nourishment that we need in order to be successful in this life. So I pray for every person who is listening to this episode entitled, We'll Go Through This Together. You're always with us, whether we're on the mountain or in the valley, whether we're in the dark or in the light, you're with us. And then you've said that you'll never leave us nor forsake us. So Lord God, help us to just rely on you, to lean not to our own understanding, but we will rely totally on you to lead us to safety, to lead us to our destination, to help us become what you created us to be, so we can shine in this world. Not so much us, but your light to shine in the midst of this dark and corrupted world. Help us, oh God, to understand that the fight is not ours. It belongs to you. So help us to just trust you and to brag about how good you really are. Help us to just know that there is nothing that can separate us from your love. There is nothing, no weapon, no source, nothing can hurt or harm us as long as we place our total trust on you, because you will lead us to safe pastures. We give you praise in advance for what you're going to do, and we ask all these blessings in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Well, that is it for today or tonight. We thank you guys for tuning in to our episode entitled, We'll Go Through This Together. I'm Pastor Phil with Full of Life Ministries. We are here to serve you. We love you with the love of Christ. Continue to pray for us as we pray for you. Please support us financially. Please follow us on Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. Help us to continue to spread this message of hope to every person who needs it. We believe that this message of hope will touch the lives of people all around the world. So please continue to share these episodes with your friends and your family, your co-workers, your church family, whoever it may be. Allow God's word to minister grace to their souls and to bring healing to their situation. This is Pastor Phil with Full of Life Ministries. We'll see you at the next episode. People of God, let's continue to do this in Jesus' name. God bless.